Hello, and welcome to Mappedin. My name is Thomas, and I will be leading you through a demo of our mapping and wayfinding solutions as it pertains to stadiums, arenas, and any other type of entertainment venue. Whether you're watching this with a background from marketing, operations, or IT, I will be sure to cover some of the issues you may be having and how Mappedin can solve them. Before I begin, let's get a quick understanding of what Mappedin is. In short, Mappedin is a digital mapping and wayfinding platform that enables a large host of digital experiences. The core of our business can be summarized as two main value propositions. One, we transform CAD files to be utilized as digital assets that can be changed in real time to always reflect the most up-to-date venue layout. Two, we allow digital experiences to live on top of the maps when fans and visitors interact with them. My personal favorite is, of course, the turn-by-turn wayfinding feature. As much as I do enjoy talking, I would much rather show you how we build the maps and how visitors and guests interact with them. So let's get started.
So what we are looking at right now is the CMS, which is also known as the map editor. Here we can see we have a CAD file. It's a static map that really should be rendered in a digital format. And what we do with them is pretty simple. We take the CAD file and we build out the layers, ensuring to digitize every aspect of the venue. Here you can see me untoggling the different layers and bringing the venue to life. So when we're done with it, it's an exact digital replica of your CAD file, allowing you to select certain areas of your venue for customization. The blue lines represent the wayfinding aspect of our maps, which is of course the navigation. The yellow and red circles respond to the location data, which can be anything from a ticketing booth, merchandise store, or anything else you want to be searchable by your visitors. The CMS, also known as the map editor, can also hold location data and metadata associated with specific points of interest around your venue. This data itself can live in the CMS or can live in your current database and can be synced via an API every night to ensure that the location data is up to date. Here we see a location called Captain Morgan's Rum Bar. When we click the location, we'll be able to see it highlighted on the map for ease of access. You'll be able to see the location name. You'll be able to see the type of location it's associated with, and all of this is fully customizable. When we go past extended information that you see here, this is anything that the visitors and fans will be able to see on the front end maps that the CMS powers. For example, we can see that Captain Morgan's Rum Bar is associated with a food and beverage category, meaning if fans and visitors search for food and beverage on the front end maps, Captain Morgan's location will be highlighted as a relevant point of interest. Additionally, you can add different colors to the point of interest. You can add a logo to show up on the map so people are familiar with it. You can add a location picture, which is also utilized for our seat view functionality, allowing you to click on a section and being able to see the specific view from that seat, as well as the metadata, such as descriptions of the locations, phone numbers, hours of operation. And lastly, you can add links, and the links feature allows you to embed certain links that you would like associated with that point of interest. And this can be anything from linking out to a ticketing provider, linking out to a menu board where individuals can order food directly off the maps themselves. We've had a chance to dive into the CMS where the map changes are ultimately made. Let's take a look at the front end maps that fans and visitors can interact with. The CMS that we were just in will render the maps and push them into three main types of user consumption. One, we are looking at a digital website map that will ultimately replace static PDF maps on a website. The next format is an SDK, allowing you to embed the maps within a mobile application, and which allows for full range of customizability, allowing you to have the navigation and a sense of customization. Lastly, the maps can live on a touchscreen that you may have in and around the venue. If there is no need for a mobile application as of right now, but you would like the users to be able to use their phone to navigate, the website maps that we provide are fully responsive to a user's device, allowing them to navigate and search the entire venue from the convenience of their phone. So now let's take a look at the maps themselves. As you can see, they're fully interactive 3D maps that you can customize. The maps do come full turnkey solution, meaning at the beginning, there's nothing for you to do other than approve the renderings. Here we see we can toggle multiple levels of the stadium and ultimately also get navigation and points of interest in and around the venue. Anything that we see highlighted here lives within the map and you are able to navigate to it. So as a fan, I have the ability to search the entire venue prior to coming or while at the game, allowing me to select the locations that I either want to travel to or get information on. So let's take a look at level 2. Here we notice there are multiple locations that I would most certainly want to visit. For example, here we have the Nacho Bar. This tab will populate the metadata that you have inputted within the CMS. What you can also do is, of course, get the navigation to the Nacho Bar. I can also take them with me as a step-by-step direction, and I can also toggle escalators, elevators, if I am bound to a wheelchair or unable to take the escalators. The maps themselves can also update to provide indoor positioning technology, meaning instead as a user putting in my starting location, this will populate as use your current location, meaning you will see a blue dot following you around as you travel to the destination that you have chosen.
So there you have it, Mappedin's digital mapping and wayfinding capabilities. With a large network of partners in the space, the maps can host and integrate with a number of other in-venue experiences. As mentioned earlier, maps are a utility that need to be leveraged in this digital era. We know our way around stadiums, and we think your fans should too. Thanks for tuning in.